Alrighty guys, in the last episode, we finished up episode 5, we did the heist, and we took down the Contessa for good. She is now in prison, where she belongs, that crazy spider lady. But Neela, on the other hand, got a promotion from Interpol, the cop agency, and so now she's even more powerful than she already was, even though she has been betraying everybody. But anyways, enough with that. In this episode, we're going to start episode 6, and of course, every time we start a new episode, we do a bottle video. So, He Who Tames the Iron Horse, let's start it up and see what we're dealing with here. Alrighty.
Following the trail of spice shipments, we made our way up to Nunavut Bay, Canada. The secret hub of Jean Bisson's shipping empire. As a young man, he trekked across Canada to strike it rich during the gold rush of 1852. An avid prospector, he took some chances and ended up buried alive in an avalanche. Miraculously, the quick freeze kept him alive, and 120 years later, thanks to global warming, he thawed out.
That's one way to thaw out.
He dreams of taming the wild north, damming every river and chopping down all the trees, with progress delivered at the sharp end of an axe. Shipping spice for the Claw Gang proved a lucrative way to bankroll his one-man war against nature. And yet, I have to feel a little sorry for him. He's just a normal guy from the 1850s. Back in his day, he'd be a hero, but today, he's a villain. Either way, that man's got more than his fair share of the clockwork parts. What a low-tech guy like Jean Bisson is doing with robot parts is a mystery. I almost don't want to know. But as always, it's only a matter of time before I find out.
Yeah, that's right. Sly Cooper and the gang in. He Who Tames the Iron Horse. Alright, so... yeah. Now we get to see a snowy place. We haven't seen a snowy place. It's the only snowy place in the game. But we're finally here. It's pretty cool. Some of the new techniques we get to learn. There's a ton more power-ups. Not a ton, you know. Each character gets a new power-up every place we go to. So the new one is the Huffer Pack, which is really useful for Bentley. Then we've got... I think this is the newest one, Raging Inferno Flop. I never really buy any power-ups from Murray unless I just have the coins and want to do it. And here it is, Silent Obliteration. Really useful power-up for Sly. It helps out in taking out enemies sneakily, you know what I mean? And it will finish off juggled enemies without attracting attention. You don't have enough coins to buy... okay, yeah, that's not part of the description, but I'll definitely try to, while I'm collecting bottles, I don't know, maybe after I collect the bottles off camera or something, I will go around and get all three of the treasures and return them so that I have enough money to get the power-ups. So yeah, anyways, let's get to doing our stuff. Of course, we have to do the reconnaissance mission with Sly. And that is the reconnaissance mission right there, but of course we are going to collect the bottles in this video, and then in the next video we will start doing we'll start doing all the missions, guys. So I will talk to you after I collect the bottles. See you then.
you jump and press the circle button. Circle button.
Alrighty guys, I finally figured out where the 30th bottle was. I've been running around for a few minutes looking for it. It's been right over here, pretty close to the safe house, or the town where the safe house is out, where it's at. So, yeah, I felt kind of dumb about that, but there's 30 out of 30 bottles, guys, so that pretty much does it for the bottle video. I do have a treasure on my back, so, we're gonna go ahead and return to the safe house and, put that or sell that safely, if you know what I mean. And I also pickpocketed a ton of guards while getting the bottles, and so I think we're gonna sell all the stuff in the next episode, guys. So stick around for that when I sell all this stuff and see how much I make. I'm definitely gonna be able to purchase the Sly power up after that, and probably someone else's. But until next time, guys, I will talk to you then.